the complete privacy solution, and we have here Shailesh Varudkar from RedMoff, who would be taking you through this demo.
We're the last guys. Really enlightening day, especially Mr. Shastri's views on we're not 100% protected. So we're trying our bit in terms of seeing whether we can make it like Dettol 99.9%. Okay. What we'll do is we'll take you through what we intend to do, what we're doing, okay, and then take you through the demo of what we have developed. We are a relatively young company. There are people with 20 years experience in this space. We're just 3 years experience. We're a small company based in Pittsburgh and Hyderabad and Bombay. Okay. Just initial slides. I'll take all the questions later because I think that would be better in terms of time. Everyone is talking about that mobile is the key issue nowadays, okay, in terms of cybersecurity, and everyone believes that. I'm not taking you through Gyan, I'm just moving fast in respect of time. So what we did was, last week we analyzed top 50 apps that have been used by Indians. 13 of them are of Indian origin, 17 of them, 17 of them are of Chinese origin, and 20 of them are from the rest of the world. Now, when you analyze what traffic these apps generate, 99% of this traffic actually goes out of the country, okay? Even from those apps which are originated from India or developed by Indians. Why? Because Indians like free stuff. There are free SDKs available. People just use those free SDKs to develop these apps. Now, I'll talk about what these free SDKs, when you use in your app, what happens. Effectively, what it means is it's become very easy for people to understand what is the behavior of your enterprise users as well as consumers, okay? Because these SDKs are capturing all kinds of information. We're talking about a different vector. Yes, it's been spoken about a bit, but a different vector than what has been talked a lot today, okay? Just to explain, while everyone knows about it, just to explain what I'm talking. This is a standard behavior of someone going to say, I've taken the name of NDTV, it's nothing against them, but it's generally for any site, be it Times of India, NDTV, Money Control, name it, okay? What happens is standard behavior, HTML, JavaScript gets downloaded from the site, which we think is a secure, trusted site. Embedded in that site or app are 2, 3, 4 links, okay, which go somewhere out, okay? And from them, another set of cookies, JavaScript get downloaded. And this cycle keeps on repeating. What tends to happen because of this is that by the third or the fourth instance, okay, the trusted partner whom you have trusted have lost control in terms of what links, what JavaScripts, what cookies are getting downloaded in your phone or your browser. Okay, what this means is, okay, remember I talked about the SDK. What is happening here is, things are getting loaded in your phone, be it a malware, be it a cookie, or be it a JavaScript, which has then access of your information. Now, it's basically loaded because of the way internet works. Okay, there's nothing that you and me can do, nothing that can be done unless and until you change the way, the rules of internet. Okay, I'm sorry, I'm just rushing through, okay, because most of this is known stuff. Okay, please raise your hand if you need any further query on this, okay? What it also means is, because if I just click on a site, okay, say NDTV, okay, there'll be some 100 different links or IPs that will be pinging to actually load the complete site. That gives a very suboptimal performance. The time taken to load the site is very high, okay? You'll still see the browser trying to load the site, okay? It'll mean a lot of data is getting used. Thanks to Jio, data is free, so doesn't matter any longer, okay? But the battery consumption is very, very high, and that matters a lot. If you do a research today amongst kids, okay, who use their smartphone a lot, data consumption is not a problem for them. Battery consumption is a big problem for them. And therefore, all these mobile phone companies are coming up with bigger and bigger batteries. So it's basically overall giving a suboptimal performance. Okay. What is it that effectively is getting accessed by these third-party sites or apps, okay, or SDKs, okay? Checkpoint tried to explain, okay, and they gave a live demo, and I can say all of that is true, okay? Your entire browsing history, a lot of you know that when you go to, say, Amazon, look for a shoe, and thereafter, you don't buy the shoe, in the next 10 seconds, you go to Mr. NDTV, you see the same shoe, maybe at the same price, okay? You think that's magic. It's not magic. Some company is tracking you and retargeting you. Now, that's just been a good use for marketing. That's what the companies think. That can be used for anything, analyzing your complete behavior and targeting. Other example given is, I'm sure all of you would have tried, go to a travel booking site, try to book Hyderabad-Bombay flight, okay? See the price, not do the booking, go after 2 days, okay, and bang, the price has gone up. Clear the cache and check again, you'll see the price coming down. Why? Because they've analyzed you. They know who you are, they know without you logging in, they know you're the same guy, they know you're really, really wanting that ticket, therefore they've jacked up the price. It's just smart way of doing things. Now this is just, I would say, non-harmful use of what the technology, but there are lots of other things that other people can do by getting hold of this information. Now this is just history, okay? They're talking about, they showed about chats, emails, contacts, phone book, everything is accessible, everything is picked up. Now when you download an app from Google Play, okay, the standard habit is the next button you click is okay because you've given permissions. Just look at the permissions that you've given to an app, okay? App like Torchlight, okay? Why does it need internet access, okay? Forget internet access, there are apps which will get require all the access, your phone book, your camera, your whole database that you're there in the phone. So they just want every access and you just, without looking at it, just say okay, and you give hand over the access to them, okay? For a corporate, okay, while an individual, yes, my phone book going out, you've already given your phone book out to Truecaller and therefore it's all over the place, okay? But for corporate, this information going out is getting more dangerous. There is significant loss, not just monetary, but other stuff that Mr. Shastri talked about. And lastly, okay, they have access to my camera, they have access to my mic, okay. Last year, some 6-7 months back, okay, there was a press article about Hotstar buying a Bangalore-based company. That company had developed a mobile app to track television advertisements. What it used to do is, what it has done is, there's an SDK that goes into your phone. When the television is on, okay, a high-pitched sound is actually emitted when the ad is getting played, okay? You don't know, you can't hear it because humans can't hear above a particular frequency, but the phone picks it up, okay, and relays it back to whoever saying that this is the actual viewership of the ad, okay? Mic was on. The app has access to your mic, okay, and it's always on, okay? So a lot of information gets passed about. So what's happening, just further understanding and therefore talking about RedMoth a brief, okay? When you connect to a site or an app and when it is getting loaded, okay, what tends to happen is obviously first comes direct content, which is why you've gone to that site or the app, okay? Then you have these third-party networks which are, they are syndicate partners of this site, okay? And that's where the fun and games actually start, okay? Then you get the basically direct cookies and trackers and analytics because everything is analytics, okay? Then you move on to the third-party cookies, trackers, and analytics. Then ad networks, which is an important part. Then social media. And then data brokers. Now, all is fine till this point. And then comes the dangerous part, okay? Malvertising, phishing, hackers, compromised sites, cookies, and the works. Now, when you download an antivirus, okay, what it protects you is all the known threats. Like everyone is talking about, the signature-based stuff, okay? Then there is a concept called as ad blockers. Now, what ad blockers do is block a certain set of IPs, okay, which are known, okay, and it's a static list usually. So it will block some of the stuff that I talked about. What we at RedMoth will do is actually block most of these third-party sites which are not relevant to the actual app or the site, okay? So one big thing that happens because of this is almost 50 to 80% of the traffic which is not required is blocked by us. The advantage one is that your performance gets better, okay? Two, it reduces the probability of infection because we've blocked a lot of sites. Three, okay, my friends, people like Checkpoint, I give them a better chance of ability to catch all this nonsense that is happening because they have to look at lesser traffic than what otherwise they would have, and therefore speed is important to them. So we're not saying we are a competitor, but I think it's more of symbiotic relationship. Working together with a solution like this, okay, will help generally protect 99.9%, okay? Just one quick example. When you are actually using RedMoth, you don't have any protection. We've gone to a site. I don't want to take the name of the site. You'll see the spider web, okay? There's some 179 connections and 126 cookies. And with RedMoth, it's just 5 connections, okay? So it's much cleaner. We would have blocked a lot of it. Impact, yes, what we're doing is basically we're saying we're protecting your privacy. Data that is not supposed to get out of your phone to people that is not supposed to go to, we're blocking that. That's one. Okay. Two, in a way, it gives you security because we are preventing all the malicious content, links, and activities that are happening. And obviously, three, there's an economic benefit. What we are saying is we give you much more control. Last slide before I get into the demo. There are lots of solutions that are available. There are work in progress. There's VPNs, MDNs, IIP solutions, which really provide a lot of security. But we think there's a gap in the security in terms of ability to protect ad blockers, trackers, stuff like that, which is what we handle. So by working with RedMoth, working along with any of these solutions for an enterprise user, we can provide a much higher security level. Okay, I can talk about RedMoth, but in respect of time, I will just straightway go to the demo. We're trying to take on Mr. Murphy, with doing a live demo. So what we have currently live is actually a browser controller, okay, which can be used for either a Chrome or a Firefox or a Safari browser. It's available on our site. You can download it. It's free of cost. And we have also in the final stages of releasing our app for Android phones, okay, which will take care of the complete phone, not just the browser, okay. I am showing you the demo of the app, okay. One second, I think, is it fully there? Great, okay. So when you download the app, what it will first do is scan the whole phone for various apps that are there, because everything that the phone connects to, even a browser, is an app, okay. So if you see, it's actually going, checking all the apps in the phone that you have, and giving them a score, okay? Is it a high risk, mid risk, or a low risk, okay? It'll take around 30, 40 seconds, depending on the number of apps. We've seen usually there are close to around 30 to 40 apps on an average per user. This phone seems to have 30 apps, okay? It has classified depths, sorry. No, this is a live demo that I'm doing. On this phone. Yeah, it's not. So I'm just moving on to the next function. What it has recognized is there are certain apps, okay, like Clock or a file manager, okay, it currently has internet access. So we are saying that, look, there's no need for these apps to have access to the internet. So would you like to block them? So I go ahead and block it. Okay. What it starts doing now is our algo starts working. And there are multitude of these trackers. There are advertising trackers, there are analytics trackers, social media trackers, collaboration trackers, porn trackers, which we are all realizing and we are blocking. Okay. Now the activity is complete. What has happened here is there are a few apps that are actually live at the back end. Okay. You can see CNN, Times of India, BBC News, Deccan Chronicle, and a game. Okay. So I'll just take you through, this is the basic dashboard, which is telling you what all has been currently going on in the phone. Now, if you go to the next tab, okay, this is a list of all the apps that are there. We're basically showing them in alphabetical order. The sign at the right actually tells you, okay, the various protection, the permissions that you've given to Astro File Manager. Okay, the red dot indicates it's high risk, orange dot medium risk, and obviously green dot low risk. Okay, what you can further do is, for a specific app, say for example Astro File Manager, okay, I can change the security setting that I have to none, standard or high, and I can change the access that I'm giving, only on Wi-Fi or only on mobile or none. Okay, sorry. Sorry, the connection went. So, basis individual app, you can actually change the settings if you want to. Okay. Now, if I go to live view, it's currently telling you what all is happening and what all I'm blocking. Okay. Currently, CNN is doing its round. Okay, because the app is live at the back end. Now, if I keep it here for a minute, you'll see it regularly updating basis what the phone is trying to ping, what is going through, what is not. And if I'm an advanced user, I can actually change the status. I can allow it or I can further block it. Okay. The last thing that I wanted to show was our live view. Okay. It's basically giving the spider web of the complete thing. So, sorry, I can't explain it to you here, but I think it's pretty clear there in terms of it's a very nice clean image. Okay. If I actually make the setting zero here, you'll see what I had shown earlier. Okay, that's the demo. It's a nice, simple app, very simple for people to use. What we're going to start off with, this is primarily focused to consumer segment and not to enterprise. So we've kept it as less techie as possible and as high at the back end in terms of algos that are doing the work, heavy lifting for the consumer. That's it. Thank you. It's going to be a paid app soon. Yeah, we can surely work out something.